Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to Technology Admirer. My name is Sovan and today I am going to show you guys how to connect this TV tuner card and get it up and running. The first thing that I am going to show you guys is how to connect your set-top box with the TV tuner card. For that, all you have to do is connect all the three RCA jacks that are color-coded. One end of the jacks will go inside the set-top box and the other end is going to go inside the TV tuner card. These RCA cables that I am plugging in right now are also provided inside the packaging along with the TV tuner card itself. Now do remember to connect the cable connection with the set-top box or else you will see no signal message. Now what we are going to do is connect your monitor with the TV tuner card. To do that, all you have to do is connect one end of the VGA cable to your monitor as you do normally. Take the other side of the VGA cable and connect it on the back side of your TV tuner card where it is written VGA out and also the VGA port is of blue color. To connect your computer with the TV tuner card, you will need a cable which looks something like this and it is also provided inside the packaging. But do note one thing, that you can watch TV using this TV tuner card without connecting your PC. That means this step is optional. You only have to connect your PC with this TV tuner card if you want to use the PC as well as the TV tuner card with the same monitor. Now connect one end of this cable which looks like a VGA cable to the backside of your computer where the VGA cable goes. Connect it just like any other VGA cable that you connect on the backside of your computer. Now the other end of this cable is going to go inside a port which is written as VGA in. Now simply connect it securely inside the VGA in port. And there you go. You have successfully connected your PC with the TV tuner card. Next, what we are going to connect is the 3.5mm audio cable which is also provided with the TV tuner card inside the packaging. First, connect the one end of this 3.5mm audio cable to the audio out on your computer. Now do remember that this step is also optional. You have to connect this audio cable only if you connect the PC with the TV tuner card. Now coming to the audio connection, the other end of the audio cable is going to go inside the port called PC audio on the backside of the TV tuner card. Now in this step we are going to connect external speakers with the TV tuner and I highly recommend you guys to connect an external speaker if you don't want to hear any kind of bad audio with its inbuilt speaker. To connect external speakers, all you have to do is take the 3.5mm jack that comes out from the speaker system and connect it inside the port called audio out. In the next step I am going to show you guys how to connect radio antenna cable with the TV tuner card. This step is also completely optional. If you want to listen FM radio using this TV tuner card, then only you have to connect this FM antenna. To connect this FM antenna cable, you just have to plug it in on the backside of the TV tuner card where it says antenna in. And the other end of this cable is going to give you good FM reception. Now the last thing that we are going to connect in this TV tuner card is the power adapter. Here also one end of the power adapter cable is going to go inside a port called DC 5V which is located on the backside of your TV tuner card. Just plug the cable inside the DC 5V port. That's it, you have successfully connected all the cables to your TV tuner card. Now all you have to do is plug in all the power cables from TV tuner card, monitor, set-top box, speaker system and your computer. Now after plugging in the main power cable inside the socket, all you have to do is turn on the switch. Now when you look at the TV tuner card, you will see that the red power LED is blinking because it's in standby mode. To turn it on, all you have to do is press the power button once. Now you can see it stops blinking because it is now powered on. Now if you don't see anything on your monitor, then probably it's in standby mode. All you have to do is power it on. Then only you will be able to see iball Claro TV logo on your monitor. After that, what you are going to do is turn on your music system, which is connected to your TV tuner card using the 3.5mm audio cable. The last thing that you are going to do to watch TV using this TV tuner card is turn on the set-top box. And there you go, you can see I can now watch TV using this TV tuner card. Now to use the PC, all you have to do is turn the PC on. Now to switch to PC from the TV, all you have to do is turn off the TV tuner card. As soon as you turn off the TV tuner card, you will see your desktop. And again to turn on the TV, all you have to do is turn on the TV tuner card. Now if you want more and you want to watch TV as well as work on your computer at the same time, you can do that too. For that, all you have to do is press on the PIP or picture in picture button on your remote control of the TV tuner card, and then you will be able to watch TV as well as use the computer at the same time. With this TV tuner card, you don't have to worry about any software. It's just like plug and play. That's it for this video. I hope this video was helpful. Thanks for watching and subscribe for more videos like this.